Hello. It's great to see that you've come to see us again. Isn't it, Obadiah? Obadiah? Are you eating something?
Oh, no, not eating anything.
Obadiah, you were eating something, weren't you? And that's ever so rude.
Well, I was hungry. I get grumpy when I'm hungry. You wouldn't want me to be grumpy, would you?
No, I suppose not. But what do ostriches eat, anyway?
Well, I don't know about other ostriches. Personally, I like omelettes and oranges and olives. Oh, and I really like those chocolate biscuits with yummy creamy stuff in the middle.
Oh, you mean Oreos?
No, bourbons. Sometimes I think you don't know me at all, Hannah.
Oh, Obadiah. Well, I think you'll like today's story. It's all about some people who were hungry, but who ended up having plenty to eat.
Oh.
You see, Jesus had gone out to spend some time in the countryside because he wanted to be by himself. But lots of people had followed him. Crowds followed him wherever he went because he healed people who were sick and people loved listening to the stories that he told.
I see.
So should we find out what happened next?
There are an awful lot of people here, Jesus. Thousands and thousands of them.
Yeah, I know.
The thing is, it's late and they're getting hungry and there's nowhere for them to buy anything to eat. We're going to have to send them away. They've been out by the lake all day and now they'll have to go away.
No, they won't.
5,000 people hanging round, we'll have to send them back to town.
No, we won't.
They came to see you heal the sick. Now they'll have to clear off quick. They'll go find themselves some grub in a cafe or a pub.
Hungry, 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 they're so hungry, it's past dinner time. Hungry, 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 they're so hungry, it's past dinner time.
All the things we could do, if we had some bread and honey, it's past dinner time.
He's got a point. All those people and nowhere for them to buy any food. Did Jesus send them away?
Let's see, shall we?
Don't send them away. Give them something to eat.
But we haven't got any food.
Don't any of these people bring some food with them?
Well, one little fella brought something. Not very much. Not enough to feed everybody with.
Well, what did he bring?
Come on, lad. Tell Jesus what you brought.
Bread and fishes, they're so yummy. Bread and fishes. Soon they will be in my tummy. Bread and fishes. 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. It's not an expensive dish. There's not much as you can see, just enough for me. Please don't make me share it.
That's not much good, is it? 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish for all those people. I think they will have to go back to town after all.
Do you? Let's see.
Will you let me share out this food?
Well, I don't see as it'll do much good.
Thank you for this food, Heavenly Father. Bless the bread, bless the fish, and bless all of us here.
Amen.
Now, my friends, we need to start sharing out this food to all the people.
Well, that won't take long. You'll run out before you've hardly started.
Do you think so?
I do.
Let's see, shall we? Come on guys, let's share out this bread. We need to get these people fed. Just some bread and two fishes that this little lad brought is all we've found. Come on guys, let's share out this bread. We need to get these people fed. Just some bread and two fishes that this little lad brought is all we found. But will it go around? Yes, we fed them all. Old, young, rich, poor, fat, thin, short and tall. We fed them all. We shouted grubs up and they heard the call. Oh yeah!
That's amazing! Did they really feed thousands of people with just five loaves and two fish?
Not only that, but they had 12 big basketfuls left over.
But that's impossible! How could you feed all those people and still end up with more than you started with?
Well, maybe some of the people in the crowd really did have some food with them, but they just weren't sharing. But then, once the little boy shared his food, everyone else realised it would be a good idea to share too.
Oh, maybe.
But perhaps it was just something amazing that Jesus could do, because he was God's son. There are lots of stories in the Bible about things he did, like walking on water, healing sick people, and even bringing people back to life.
You mean maybe it was a miracle?
I think it was definitely a miracle, whichever way it happened. And perhaps it doesn't really matter. I mean, sometimes we can make good things happen by sharing and being kind to people. And if someone is hungry or lonely or scared, and we make things a little bit better for them, that could be a miracle for them. Something that they think of and remember as amazing, even if we've forgotten all about it.
Life can get us down. Things that happen make us frown. Slip on a banana skin. Trip and fall into a bin. Sometimes we just wonder why. Things that happen make us cry. We get ill or hurt ourselves. But we can always tell each other. We can always tell each other. God is sad, wind us up and make us mad, call us names or pull our hair, laugh about our underwear. Sometimes we feel on our own, things that happen make us grow. Nothing seems to go our way, but we can.
a while since we did that one, isn't it, Obadiah?
It is.
Feels like a long time.
A very long time.
But
lots of things haven't happened.
And lots of things have happened since then.
Oh, yes, lots of things have happened too. It just feels like lots of things not happening.
True. Anyway, yes, we made that quite close to the beginning of the very first lockdown, didn't we?
We did.
Anyway, so yes, we
hope... I look so young in that, don't I?
So, yes, we hope you enjoyed it either for the first time or enjoyed it again, because it's the story of feeding that we were looking at in John's Gospel today. This week's quite a busy week coming up. We have
busy.
We have Messy Church next
messy
next Saturday. So if you'd like to come along, please email the address at the bottom of the screen. We also have our Little Fishes toddler group.
Fishy.
Are you all right?
I'm just trying to add a little bit of, you know, participation.
Right, okay. Yes, we also have our Little Fishes toddler group, or baby and toddler group, which is on Friday mornings between 10 and 10:30. So again, if you'd like to come to that, the email address is there. And we have our youth group for 8-year-olds to 12-year-olds on a Wednesday evening as well. Again, details at the bottom of the screen. Should we pray, or are you still... You didn't do anything for the youth group.
I know, I couldn't think of anything.
Anyway.
Youthy, it doesn't really work, does it?
No.
It's quite hard to say.
Yeah, no.
Youthy.
Yeah, no, doesn't work at
no.
all.
So no. That's why I didn't say it.
Okay. Should we pray?
Oh, yes, let's do that.
Lord God, we thank you that you came and you fed all those people. And we ask that we be open to you feeding us with your peace and your love in the coming week. Lord, be with us, whatever we are doing. Amen.
Amen.
So, we hope to see you next week in... Anyway, come and join us in anything. And we'll see you next Sunday right here in the same spot. Obadiah will be on the same perch for another episode about John's Gospel.
I might be on the other side.
You're never on the other side.
Okay, I won't be. I'll be here.
Yeah. All right. See you next week.
Bye.
Bye.